Welcome back to our session. My name is Brother Julian Mary, Knights of the Holy Eucharist. Again, the theme of this first stage of preparation is the renouncement of the spirit of the world, and we are now entering day one of the first 12 days. For a better understanding of the spirit of the world, we have this beautiful passage of the Gospel in the manual, which speaks of the blessedness, true blessedness, commonly known as the Eighth Beatitude. For a person who read the first time the Beatitude without looking the depths of those words will find it difficult to understand the beauty and the wisdom of those lines. This is the glory of the saints, unknown to the people who live according to the spirit of the world. And so our Lord made this Sermon on the Mount, so that the sound of His voice will reach the four corners of the world, to tell those who live according to the spirit of the world that there is much joy unimaginable in heaven than the little joy we experience in this world. The world can never give the soul a full satisfaction to its longings. And so our Lord gives us a glimpse of the joys of a true blessedness and its contrast to what the world's understanding of the word blessedness, success, prestige, power, honor, influence, etc., etc. Another beautiful passage specifically chosen for this day is the Gospel on the Salt of the Earth and the Light of the World, a continuation on the Sermon on the Mount. Let us look at the spirit of the world through the lenses, through these parables. The salt and the light of the world is also very striking. Salt is used to preserve. It is also used to prevent accident during winter. It is generally used to give taste. One thing that most people don't realize is that when it gives flavor, it disappears. Though it gives delightful taste, it doesn't want to be praised and is contented to be unknown. What a contrast to the spirit of the world. To further unmask the spirit of the world, let us look on a candle lit in the sanctuary. The people enjoyed its light and its brightness. Light is very much appreciated during darkness. But few things many people don't realize. While the candle is giving its light, it consumes itself by its burning heat. The flames of its love and its intense desire to give light veils the whiteness of its purity and its glory. Though the candle stands majestic on high, giving its burning flames and light, it slowly goes down unnoticed, then disappeared, totally consumed, because it wants to give its light, contented to be unknown. That's the nature of the salt and the candle chosen by our Lord in this particular gospel. When it gives totally without reserve, a total self-giving, hidden and doesn't seek applause. What a contrast to the spirit of the world. Our Lord Jesus Christ did the same, giving Himself totally without reserve, hidden and unknown. But on the other hand, it is completely different because our Lord's motive is to give glory to the Father, subjecting Himself under the law to fulfill the law and to fulfill the supreme commandment of the Eternal Father, hidden and unnoticed. Seldom we find people who has the spirit of total self-giving, if they are living and conforming themselves to the spirit of the world. Our Lord fulfills the law and the commandment of the Heavenly Father. What about us? What is our motive in doing things? Let us ask Mary, Mother of God, to help and guide us in this preparation for consecration. Mother of God is the greatest title of Our Lady and the first title of glory mentioned in the litany. The other titles follow as something which pertains to Mary, Mother of God. And so Mary was honored as the greatest among the saints and the supreme, with a supreme respect called Hyperdulia. And it is because of her eminent dignity as the Mother of God.